Paris in the springtime. What's not to love? The French capital is enduringly known as the City of Light for its revolutionary spirit, avant-garde culture, birthplace of the Age of Enlightenment, and early adoption of gas-powered street lighting. And once again, Parisian cafes and boulevards, monuments and riverbanks will bear witness to a revolution, a new enlightenment, but a different source of power. Electricity, the future of motorsport. This weekend, 18 drivers for 9 teams are going to be battling it out for the 7th round of the second season of Formula E, the first fully electric racing series right here in the very heart of this city. The championship rests on a knife edge as there's just 1 point between the top 2 drivers and 6 points between the top 2 teams. The latest chapter in the drama will be played out in the shadow of the Eiffel Tower. The iconic building was completed in 1889, just 5 years before what's regarded by some as the world's first motor race, from Paris to Rouen. The French Connection continues today through the FIA, the sport's world governing body, and they're based bang in the heart of Paris, right here at Place de la Concorde. And I'm about to meet its president, the man whose vision really created Formula E. Jean Todt, together with the rest of your team at the FIA, you really created this new sport, Formula E. Why is it so important to you, and what was your vision behind it?
It's important that a global organization like ours has a vision about what motorsport should do and where motorsport should go.
And we go racing in Buenos Aires. This is textbook stuff. Car by car, one at a time.
Look at it. Oh, did he touch the wall?
Bird takes victory in Argentina.
We are talking a lot about pollution, CO2, climate change. I felt it was important to create a specific championship which could be adapted to the needs of the cities. Politically, it was not so easy, and I must say I was already very impressed and touched last year when I saw the race in Moscow in the Red Square, because you know that are iconic places, locations in the city. So we have iconic cities and iconic location in the cities, and Paris is part of it. I like the atmosphere. I like the surrounding. I like the locations. It's for me opportunity of meeting people. It's very refreshing atmosphere. I quite like socializing with them.
And what do you think we can expect from the race this weekend? And is it Renault Edams that's going to be getting your support?
No, I mean, I give my support to the whole championship. I like good racing, but I'm not so much interested with the nationality of the team or of the driver. For me, the best racing, the best driver, the best team should win.
To read up on what the most powerful man in motorsport has to say about Formula E, visit our website, cnn.com/motorsport. The history of French motorsport spans many decades and many famous names, but none more so than that of Prost. Alain Prost has won more Grand Prix titles for his country than any other driver. His son Nico is now the man behind the wheel, under the watchful eye of his father, spurring him on from the Renault Edams garage, the French team he co-founded for Formula E. While Renault tops the team standings, Nico's second season is proving to be more difficult as he lies mid-table. My time in Paris provides a chance for a pit stop with Prost Jr. So it's time for a little tête-à-tête with Nico right now. Nico, how are you doing?
I'm good, and you?
Yeah, very well, thank you, very well. Now, your father, living Formula One legend, what was it like growing up with him?
For me, it was just a dad, you know, playing soccer with me in the garden. He was really a great dad. He never pushed me to become a racing driver, you know. I think he had the right amount of, you know, helping without pushing too much. think when your dad is doing something, you're very likely to try to follow in his footsteps. So if he's a racing driver, well, in the end, it turned out I became a racing driver.
And now, obviously, he's got a very major role in Renault Edams, the team that you're racing for. And what's it like working side by side with him?
Sometimes it could be a bit difficult, you think, but in the end, it's turned out to be really good because I think he can really sometimes be the team manager, but he can also be the dad when you need him. And also the fact that Jean-Paul is here also makes things a bit easier because not it's like he's the only owner of the team.
And Renault are doing pretty well at the moment. You've got a pretty quick car.
Now Renault's done a very, very good job. When you win, it's never the car, it's never the driver, it's never the engine, it's the whole package. And the whole package has been working quite well for us, even since the beginning of season one. Yeah, it's been a very frustrating season so far for me, probably one of the worst I've ever had. But the pace is there. You know, we've been fighting for the podium almost on every race, so if all the bad luck can go away and we can win this one, then it will be okay.
Now, as much as I'm really enjoying this mariage tea, I think it's time to hit the Parisian streets.
Okay, let's
Shall
go.
Shall we go?
Yes.
Okay, so Nico, are you going to give me a bit of a tour of Paris?
Yes, let's
Excellent.
See how good I can be.
In this?
Yeah, electric, you know,
Okay,
it's
yeah.
sunny,
the
why not?
It's busy, amazing. Let's give it a try. Away we go, Paris, here we come. So this is kind of like part car, part motorbike, really.
Yeah, it's a little bit in between. You don't have to wear a helmet, which is really nice on a day like this. When you get to a restaurant, your hair is not all messed up.
I like the way you're thinking, Nico. Very practical, very practical. So how far away are we from the Louvre?
Very good question. I actually do not know. I would think we're quite close. This is turning out to be a tour of Paris with Nico, who has no clue where he's going. So here on your right side, you have the scene with the bateau mouche.
Oh wow, the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, that's nice.
No matter how many times I've seen the Eiffel Tower, every time it still shocks me. It's so beautiful.
Especially at night when it has all the light, it's so amazing. Look how fast we are. Fan boost! Boom! I don't know, I never got it, so I don't know how it feels.
Stay tuned to find out what happens when Prost swaps a Twizy road car for a Formula E race car. And I head out to the Renault factory to meet the engineers whose work connects the technology behind both.